This city of Vancouver, the province of British Columbia, Canada, is on the edge of its seat, and the puck hasn't even dropped. Imagine how the players must feel. 37-year-old Tim Thomas didn't even make the NHL till he was in his 30s, has been the most consistent player in this series, but he hasn't won on the road. Roberto Luongo won the Olympics here. He beat the Blackhawks in Game 7 here. He's played his best here and needs his best here tonight. Vancouver Canucks start Ryan Kesler at center ice. His wingers, with Mason Raymond out of the lineup, are Yannick Hansen and Chris Higgins against Patrice Bergeron, Mark Recchi, and Brad Marchand. One game, winner take all. Recchi starts out, and here's Brad Marchand on Bieksa. Couldn't make his curl and drag move, but he makes a pass. Here's Peverly, centering. Krejci can't get the puck. It's loose, and it bounces through the blue. Kevin Bieksa calmly put the puck off the head of Rich Peverly to center. Johnny Boychuk to Peverly, and in deep. Peverly after the puck, Salo's after him. Here's Milan Lucic. Reverse the puck. Salo was there for Vancouver. Up the boards, a race for the puck. Daniel Sedin gets there first. Henrik right behind him takes the pass. Burrows in front. Henrik! Stopped by Thomas with some help from Seidenberg.
Oh, no shortage of action. This crowd is jacked up. The place is buzzing. Everybody looking towards Luongo. What does he do? Hits his glove first, then it's there for the rebound, and he saves a goal. At the other end, Henrik Sedin holds on, and at the last second, Krejci, who had that great chance, was on the back check and forced him to not get the shot that he wanted.
Henrik had one bounce back to him. Christian Ehrhoff looks up ice, finds Alex Burrows. Into the attack, Henrik's in front, Daniel coming up late, backhander, Thomas stopped and looks behind. It looks like he's got it. Sedins have come close a couple of times. What a pace, as you might expect. Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final. Right off the faceoff, here's Brad Marchand for Boston, trying to carry the puck into the middle of the ice. He turns back into the crowd in front, they score! Patrice Bergeron from Brad Marchand, and Boston has scored first. It's 1-0 Bruins.
The all-important first goal, and this comes off yet another faceoff play. Right now, you just get a real sense of urgency whenever the faceoff battles are there, and right now, this is a lost draw by the Boston Bruins. But they end up retrieving the puck. Marchand, as Glenn talked about, such a big player. Three Vancouver Canucks within the vicinity. Look at no active sticks. Burrows takes a quick peek. Two players in their position. Bad sticks. Lucky break. Off the post and in. And just like that, Boston gets that so important first goal.
Ander right up the middle. Tip to Tambellini. Kesler stopped by Thomas. An end-to-end rush, and Kesler and Tambellini combined for a chance on Tim Thomas. Stretch pass, tipped by Kesler to Jeff Tambellini. Kesler got the shot, Thomas made the save. Back the puck comes for Daniel. To the blue line, and Chris Tanev in for Henrik Sedin. His little back pass along the boards, Alberts gets it. Henrik Sedin, Burrows in front, centering pass, Burrows trying to jam it in, Thomas is down, and the puck is underneath him, safely outside of the goal line.
And that's the kind of shift that you expect from the Sedins, and it started to happen in the third period of Game 6, the down low plays, the ability to cycle, and there for Henrik, just trying to get the puck to the net, but look at Thomas, anchors his foot against the post, gets down and stops it.
Turns quickly, dumps the puck in for Alex Burrows. Seidenberg beat him to it to Chara. He waits, turned it over. Burrows hangs on, shoots it. Chara made the save. Zdeno Chara turned it over. Zdeno Chara made the save.
It's amazing what you can do when you panic after making a mistake, but that's a big body to try to get it through.
That's a big save. Pass to the blue line, Seidenberg, shot, Luongo stopped it, rebound, Lucin bouncing in front of the net, Marchand, wraparound, stopped by Luongo, no, it's in the net, Wraparound goal by Brad Marchand. The Bruins have a 2-0 lead.
Rebound control, always critical, but right now with so much on the line, this line for the Boston Bruins has just been able to raise its intensity. They've been able to win the loose puck battles. Marchand keeps it alive. Luongo runs into his partner, and there it goes off of the stick of Luongo. Watch the battle in front as Alberts actually doesn't get in the way. Daniel comes across and the puck over the line in a desperation play. But how about the play of Brad Marchand? And look at the hands, the quickness, keeps his feet moving and stays on that puck.
Kevin Bieksa gives him the puck with some speed. Goes by Kelly at center. Hits by Sagan. Gets the puck to the corner. Alex Burrows is there against Ryder. To the blue line. Kevin Bieksa shoots. Thomas the save. Backhand shot. Either Chara or Thomas got that. Alex Burrows. Daniel Sedin to the front of the net. That went off a leg. And now there's going to be a penalty call for the first time in the game. And it'll go against the Boston Bruins. Zdeno Chara. And Vancouver will get a power play, and man, do they need to score here. Kessler and the Sedins back on. Gregory Campbell won the faceoff, and the puck takes a crazy bounce, and it's a Boston bounce. Here's Bergeron, shorthanded to the net, hold down, and it will be... No, the puck got into the net. That's a goal instead of a penalty. Bergeron got the puck to the back of the net, and it's 3-0 Boston on a shorthanded goal.
In September of 2005, Tim Thomas was preparing for a second season in Finland. Andrew Raycroft and the Bruins had a contract dispute, so they offered him the first one-year deal of his career. He said no. He didn't want to move his kids again. He didn't think he'd get a fair shot. He had to be talked into it. They even sent him down to the American Hockey League at the beginning of the year. But midway through the season, he grabbed the net and solidified his career. Jim, he's 20 minutes away from the Conn Smythe Trophy and the Stanley Cup.
Johnny Boychuk to Andrew Ferris. Up the middle to Paille, stripped of the puck by Edner. Here comes Daniel Sedin. Hanson is with him. Daniel's backhander. Thomas hangs onto the puck, and he was bumped. And Tim Thomas made the save as Daniel decided not to give the puck to Hanson and take it to the net with a backhander himself. Tim Thomas still hasn't been beat. 3-0 Boston, third period. Phil Pritchard, keeper of the cup, polishing it, ready for presentation. Canucks have pulled their goaltender with 3 minutes to go. Luongo's on the bench for the extra attacker. A centering pass picked off by Mark Recchi to center for Marchand. Now it's a foot race. Marchand after it, had his stick lifted. Henrik Sedin back for the puck. No icing on the play, but the puck comes out to center. Burrows could only knock it down. Empty net. Here's Brad Marchand. Shoots and scores. And the Boston Bruins have a 4-0 lead with 2 minutes and 44 seconds to go, and the celebration has started on the ice and on the bench. Can you imagine how Mark Recchi must feel inside right now? And how the captain of the Canucks must feel on the other side? In the last 30 seconds, Canucks would like to get one. Tim Thomas looking for his fourth shutout of the playoffs, stops the puck at the side of the net. Zdeno Chara off the glass, down the ice. Bieksa is back. No icing here. It's over. It's an original sixth Stanley Cup for Boston. The Bruins are NHL champions.
About the playoffs by Tim Thomas, 37 years old. You think back when he was drafted in 1994 when Vancouver lost to the New York Rangers, drafted 217th. No one believed in him. With a season of having the best save percentage ever since they kept the stat in 82. What a finals.
The Boston Bruins had to win three game sevens to get the Stanley Cup. What an incredible playoff run. Congratulations to Jeremy Jacobs, Cam Neely, Peter Chiarelli, and Claude Julien, the city of Boston, the Bruins fans, and most importantly, the Bruins players. Great job. Zdeno Chara, it's my honor to present you with the Stanley Cup.
And the Boston Bruins have the Stanley Cup.